I got a little story about some paint that's made with chalk. Why I got my favorites and the rest, well, we'll talk. I put it all together on this tube that's made for you. I hope you stay to the end so you can have some paint fun too. Let's get started, everybody. So, you got your piece of furniture? You ready to paint it? It's all prepped, it's ready, it's beautiful. What are you gonna paint it with?
What paint?
What paint, Sue? What paint do I use? I wanna answer that question. Here's what I've decided. The only way to fully explain to you what paint to use and why is to tell you a little bit about my painting journey. One led me to the next, and they will explain why this worked and this didn't. This is the best for this, this is the best for this. Don't use this, use this, okay? Let's go. When I first started painting, I made my own chalk style paint. That's all I knew. I didn't know anybody else existed. I just knew that I wanted paint that would adhere to furniture, and I knew enough to know that regular latex paint wasn't gonna do that. I knew that I needed some kind of chalk or clay in my paint to make it stick to furniture. So what I did is I scoured Home Depot and Lowe's, and I would go to their oops section, and when someone would mess up on a color, I'd be like, ooh, I'll take that color. $5? Yes, $5. $5, I'll take that paint. So I would take it home and I would add my own recipe to it that I found on YouTube. Here's the benefit of it. It is the least expensive way to go. You can choose a variety of colors. It does adhere to the furniture. It can sometimes be a little gritty. It will distress around the edges if you want it to, but it will not blend as well as the next paints that I'm gonna talk to you about. So I'm going down my little journey, my little painting journey. That wasn't enough. I wanted more. I wanted my paint to do more. I've heard about these chalk style paints, and I've heard that they can do kind of magical things that this homemade version couldn't do. So I start researching and I find Annie Sloan chalk paint. Ding, 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 ding. I loved it. I didn't love the price tag. But here, let's just take that out of the equation, shall we? All small batch, independent chalk paints are a little bit on the pricey side. There, we don't need to compare and contrast their prices. They're all expensive, but they're worth it. Tried out Annie Sloan, and I liked the color choices. I wasn't thrilled. They were very traditional for me, a little bit sedate, a little bit on the multitude of grays, but as far as the paint goes, I really enjoyed it and I liked using it. I didn't like buying it. Why? What's the big deal, Sue? Well, you only get it from independent retailers, and I found that whenever I would go to this retailer to buy the paint, I left feeling this big. I was just starting out on my paint journey. And I felt like, what, I was always doing something wrong. You're supposed to use the brush, you have to use the wax, you can't use any substitutes, you must put your brush going this way or this way. There's just a lot of rules. So I decided to go to one of her demos and maybe I could learn. And I left there feeling this big because I was starting to know enough to know what I didn't know and what I did know. And I was starting to go, I don't think I have to do it that way. But basically, I got the feeling that this paint was designed for people who really want rules to follow and don't deviate, who never forget to wash out their paintbrushes. And it was more like, I can't follow all this. And so I kind of just literally, I just moved away from the paint, literally. That being said, I'm gonna give it a thumbs up because it is really good paint. All right, moving on. So now, I just realized I still want to take my painting to another level. I still want to be able to blend more and to play with color a little bit more. And so I found Debbie's Design Diary chalk and clay paint. So I'm looking at this paint, and first of all, I found it because the colors, there's red and there's pink and there's green and there's blue and there's, oh my God, I was just, I love the colors. So that's what drew me. I was also drawn to Debbie because she's hilarious and was teaching me through her videos how to break the rules, how to have fun, how to enjoy the paint. And I was just realizing this is the world I want to be in. It's not even about the paint as much as, yeah, that's the team. That's the team for me. We're gonna play and have some fun, and we're gonna do what people tell us not to do. I'm in! Give me my jersey! This is what's great about Debbie's Design Diary paint. It's no VOC. Okay, not low, I mean it's no. And what is magic about this paint is because it's made with clay and chalk and pigment and nothing else, it can be reactivated with water even days after you've painted. Sue, why do I need to spray water and have it reactivate? I don't know about you, but I can't finish a project in a day. All right, and I like to blend and I want to put different colors on and I want to pull colors off. So being able to spritz a little water and play with that paint was like magic. It's thick and it's like clay. And at first you're like, what the hell is happening here? Am I playing with mud or with paint? But then I realized there's so much you can do with this paint. You can scrape it on, paint it on, scrape it off, layer it. You can do like a stucco pattern with it, Venetian plaster. I even host a show that's called What Can't This Paint Do? Here's what can be challenging if it's your first time using this paint. At least it was for me. You take the paint and you pick out your color. Yes. You take your brush, it's thick, and you put it on and you go, okay, all right, this is different. And all of a sudden it dries. Well, it's so filled with clay and chalk that it lightens up like five shades. And you're like, what's happening here? That's not the color. That's not the color I paid for. And then you get it all done and you realize, okay, I still need to put the top coat on. When you put your wax or your big top or your polyurethane or whatever you like to use, you put that on the top. And then all of a sudden, it's gonna get really dark. And you're gonna go, that's not the color I paid for. It's like this roller coaster ride that's like crazy town. Then it dries. And then you buff it. And then you go, oh yeah, that ride was worth it. The other paint that I very much enjoy is Dixie Belle. Well, if I'm so in love with DIY, why would I go to Dixie Belle? DIY's colors are rich and deep and yummy, but they don't run the gamut of colors that I often need. Sometimes I need a bright purple or orange or Kelly green, right? Sometimes some primary colors, like really vibrant. And that's when I found Dixie Belle and went, ooh, let me check this out for a second. So Dixie Belle is WYSIWYG. Right? What you see is what you get. If you pick that amethyst jar and you put your paintbrush in, it's that same color. And you put it on your piece, it's the same color. And it dries, it's the same color. And you put the top coat on, it's the same color. It's self-leveling and doesn't require a top coat. I can blend with it. It's a little bit more challenging, only because, like I said, if I start blending with it and then come back in a few hours, it's dry. There's no like going back in and reconstituting it with a spritzer bottle. So that's my journey. That's my paint journey. I hope you learned something. Please feel free to comment below. Is there a paint you want me to try out? Do you completely disagree with me? I dare you. No, it's okay. Is there something that you would like to see some of these paints offer? Is there a color you'd like to see that you don't see? Tell me what your favorite is and why. I would love to hear. All right, guys. See you soon.